Okay, I'm just gonna give the ignorant Canadian point of view on this, but why is it that everyone in America freaks out over blizzards? Why? Is it because, like, cities are never prepared for blizzards? Is that why? Are they, like, never well-equipped enough to get rid of all the snow? Because everywhere in Canada, it's no big deal, and down in America, there are, like, goddamn hurricanes and tornadoes every other day of the week. I mean, you know, not every day of the week, but... like, people never make a rise out of those kind of things like they do blizzards and snowstorms in America. Like, what is the problem? It's just frozen rain. That's all it is. That's all it is. The only difference is that it stays afterward. It doesn't just wash down a drain. I don't know. I don't understand. Again, there's your ignorant Canadian opinion, because I'm sure that there's a very good reason. And I'm just not picking it up, I guess. Anyway, we're gonna play as Gamma. It's just, oh my god, it's all over Twitter, and I'm just like, shut up. It's like... And I know, it's because, like, it's so normal here in Canada for there to be, like, so much more snow. And even parts of the U.S., it's more normal. But it's, like, as soon as you get below, like, that first top row of states, everyone, like, shits their pants every time there's a blizzard. And I don't get it. I don't get it. There's, I don't know. Excellent. Stay off the roads. Stay inside. Fill the bathtub with water. Wait for the storm to be over. That's all you do. It's very simple.
I'm your brilliant creator! You're the second of my E100!
I love his voice.
E102.
I'm gonna call you Mr. Butlertron. Hello, Wesley.
Gamma.
Would you like some tea, Wesley? I just realized how much better Gamma's entire story would be if he was Mr. Butlertron from Clone High. Let me use my arm cannon to pulverize our enemies, Wesley. Let me go over to the door.
The shooting range is through this door. Your big brother, E101 Beta, is there practicing.
A wise parenting choice to not make me an only child. Wesley. I can't start with this shit already in Gamma's story. Oh my god, we've just been born. We're going to the final egg. We're going to be playing Gamma's levels. On the Dreamcast controller, you'll press X or B. Press and hold it in to bring up your little laser targeting thing. And once the target's locked on, you let it go and it does like little homing shots. So bit of a third person shooting here. Feels like very arcade-like because there's like a time limit on everything, which I really do enjoy. I really like Gamma's levels. I definitely more well done than like the Tails and Eggman stages from Sonic Adventure 2. That's always been my problem with Sonic Adventure 2. The Sonic and Shadow stages are very much like apples and oranges in terms of the appeal. You know, like you'll either like one or the other. But I think it's pretty safe to say that the shooting stages and treasure hunting stages are way better implemented in Sonic Adventure 1. I think that's pretty objective to say. I did not enjoy the Knuckles and Rouge stages in Sonic Adventure 2 for the most part. They had some great ideas for like level design, but they're just so frustrating. And the Tails and Eggman stages, I mean, I think those are the worst part of the game. Just the freaking worst. But oh man, the Gamma stages. Oh, am I supposed to go downstairs? Let me go down to the ground floor, Wesley. Let me get the camera stuck, cause it's a piece of shit. Wesley. Oh, there you are. There you are, Wesley.
Good job, Gamma. I didn't think you had what it takes.
Oh, dude, Gamma's always has what it takes, man. That sentence needs some work, but that's fine.
Okay then, Gamma.
All right, here's my test, man. The final egg wasn't my test, but this is.
Must be able to pass it. So pay attention to what I say.
Oh man, I sure hope I don't have to kill my brother. Man, that would really suck. That would really start my betrayal arc. Especially, you know? To treat us like objects rather than living things inside of objects. That'll really send me over the edge about one third of the way through my campaign. So you better watch it. Wesley. Alright, dude, let's do it! He's got two arm cannons, so the fact that he's holding one arm cannon in the caressing palm of another arm cannon. That's the real confusing thing about this here. So anyway, this is tap B the boss fight, or X I guess. You can tap either one. I'll tap B this time. There, look at that. I tapped X for the first two and then tapped B for the third one, just to mix it up a bit. But there we go. Took less than 7 seconds. To be exact, it took 6.97 seconds. 96, sorry. Good Lord, Will. Can't do math. Not at this hour. Not at this hour. Actually, what time is it even? 9:30, is it? Something like that. My phone's actually within reach this time. It is 9:33. Check that shit out. Was I performing to your satisfaction?
I had a funny feeling there was more to you than meets the eye.
Oh my god, is that seriously like a Transformers thing just because they're rope? I'm sure it was. I'm sure that was Sega's attempt.
So you want to come along with us, eh?
And then the best thing is that I can picture all these robots sounding the exact same. Like, I know they don't. Well, actually, I think they do. I think they do have all the same voice, like when they're all lined up. So Beta's just like, no, let me come with you, Wesley. Like, it's just like a different pitch. Wesley, please. Oh, perfect. And then this cutscene again. Perfect. Can I just like skip it? I can't even skip. That's right. That's another thing they took out of. That's another thing they added in the DX version. I think you're able to skip the cutscenes after you've seen them. Whereas in this one, no such luck. They still do look great though. Like, I really do enjoy the cutscenes in this game. They look fantastic for 98 standards. Okay, oh, what's this now? Oh, this is a familiar setting, it's just we're seeing it from the other side. We always came in here as an intruder and an infiltrator. Now we're actually the worker. We're scrubbing the floors. We're cleaning the toilets. We're balancing the checkbooks. On the first round of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? It doesn't really seem like a game show.
You, the elite.
Come on. That's ridiculous.
To hear a very special announcement.
That's not a complete sentence. Okay.
Behold, it's a tailed frog. Very unique.
So what are the other two screens for if only the center one is showing the frog? I don't know, froggy. Yeah. Froggy! I will get this froggy for you, Wesley. No, I will. No, I will, Wesley. No, I will, Wesley. I love this just thought of like these four robots who all talk and sound the exact same except their pitches are different. Like all just bickering among themselves. Don't make me vaporize you, Wesley. Wesley, you will never have a chance, Wesley. I will be the one to catch the frog. No, I will catch the frog, Wesley. Yeah, now we gotta go to... Oh god, I'm getting stuck. I love how nobody... Like, let me go over and talk to someone. Check this out. Ah, please, don't kill me! What, a frog? I saw him going to that into that hotel, yeah. The flavor text with Gamma is so great because it's either people panicking when they see him or they don't even acknowledge the fact that he's this giant killer robot walking around. I love it. Let me see if I can find someone else to talk to. Let's see. Is there anyone else? Yeah, oh, I found someone. Hey, what's up, Wesley? Hey, what are you? Is there some kind of costume party going on at Twinkle Park? I'm cosplaying as my favorite anime, Madoka Magica, Wesley. This is the first time I've seen the trains on strike. Like, you're talking to this giant killer robot about the strikes. Oh man, I need to collect this emblem. I can't believe I never collected that. I would like a Big Mac. What are you? Please don't bug me. I'm right in the middle of a big decision. You're working at a McDonald's. The devil's a part-timer right now. What are you doing, man? What are you? Oh, you're saying the... Wait. No, I don't want to talk to you. I want to talk to the guy at the counter. I thought I was talking to the dude. Hi, sir. I wonder who has enough money to afford sending a robot to shop for him. You know, I'm glad they've addressed the exact same problem that I just addressed a couple episodes ago with the whole, like, how does the evil genius that builds robots always have money? So I guess, doesn't that technically... If someone's making that assumption, then I guess it could be technically implied canon that Robotnik is some sort of, like, you know, crazy, like, billionaire person who just wants to, Wow, it's a robot. Well, come to think of it, I think I saw one back at the hotel, yeah. I guess it could be implied through that dialogue that, yeah, Robotnik has a lot of money to be able to create all this stuff. I guess. I mean, I know that that's just the most likely, you know, explanation anyway, but it's kind of cool to hear it actually, like, mentioned. Hello, you're looking for, Mr. Frog? I'm afraid that I don't see anyone with that name staying at the hotel. Well, it was worth a try. It was worth a try. Is that another guy right there? I want to talk to just everyone as Gamma. My company is on strike, so I can't go to work. Hee hee. What a bummer. Not! Oh my god! Oh shit! Pew pew pew! Oh my god! Sick burn, bro! Stick it to the man! Oh my god. He just said not. Whoa, why is this one yellow? Hey. Don't miss with the fence. Why was that yellow for a second? Now I'm really... Oh man. What the heck? I'm Mr. Know-It-All, let me clue you in. You shouldn't just go button mashing. Pressing the action button as fast as you can, hold it down and aim, then let go. Yeah. Did you know that? Yes, I did, Wesley. I'm a pro strats 420-360 no-scope son of a bitch, Wesley. All right, let's go to Emerald Coast. Enough screwing around. Emerald Coast is great, man. And it follows the Sonic path in Gamma's story rather than the more open, Big the Cat version. So it's kind of cool. Basically, it's essentially the exact same level. I think they put in like a few extra platforms here and there, since Gamma can't really maneuver in the way Sonic can. He's still pretty fast though. I gotta give Gamma credit. I think he moves at the perfect pace, because you can like push like not all the way on the control stick, and he like moves at like an okay pace on flat ground, or you can just motor right on through. Yeah, see like here. Yeah, this is where they put that extra platform. There we go. Since he can't do shit, dog. There we go. Kill him. It's all good. The idea is that the counter is always counting down rather than counting up. So it's less about beating the stage as fast as possible and more about like a survival. And the way you can rack up more time is by comboing shots. So I think it's a really fun, underrated playstyle in Sonic Adventure. People always harp on about Gamma's story. And Gamma's story is great. I'm not going to get into detail about the story because everyone who cares already has their opinion or their thoughts about it. But I think it's the playstyle that's not touched upon enough. I think it's great. It's so arcade-like and it's fast-paced without it being like dependent on the player, I guess, which is kind of cool because that's the way Sonic is. Like Sonic has the counter going up. I've explained that in a YGPT. The counter goes up. So it's more of a matter of wanting to break a record, whereas with Gamma, the counter is down, so it's a race against the clock, meaning the time is actually a threat rather than like an invitation to a challenge, which completely changes the implications of the playstyle, like right down to the most basic of concepts, which is so cool. Does not compute, does not compute. Does not have the cool 90s stylings that the hip kids are into, no Wesley.
Location unknown. This presents a problem.
I love how Gamma assesses situations. He assesses it with a naive comedic twist on it, which is something that the other robot characters in the franchise never really got down like Gamma did. Like, if Gamma had actual, emotions, he is almost kind of like happy-go-lucky and cocky in a way, because he always assesses things comedically like that, but never really panics, which is something that's kind of interesting. So now we've got just a bunch of chow, very nice. The tenors seem to be out of tune, Wesley. Bring out the basses. This chorus is the worst. 1 star out of 5 on TripAdvisor. Oh, okay, hey. What's up, Tikal? I like how Tikal is not one bit shocked at the robot either. It's like, I've never seen technology of your kind in my time before, but you're cool. I'll just talk to you. You're almost 3 times my height, but that's okay. That's fine. Yeah, he is, sort of. Except in every game he's in where he's depicted as a monster. She's, of course, referring to Chaos in this cutscene.
This protection allows them to continue seeing in peace. Even I was surprised the first time I saw him. Now my father is trying to take their sacred home. It seems his heart is closed off to us all. My true hope is that someday we'll understand each other.
What is heart? What is heart does not compute. Error, error, error. Wesley. Thank you for that plot dump, Wesley.
No, here's the real one. My frog is the right one.
Yeah, this is the bickering I was talking about. All the robots are like, I have the frog. No, the frog is mine. No, I have the right one. There's another Sonic shorts about this scene where they one of them gets a box of cereal and the other one gets shoes. And then I think the third one's like, I have a bomb. I've implanted it on Sonic. Just press this button to destroy him. And Eggman's like, excuse me, but is what you're holding by any chance a frog? And the robot holding the button's like, no. Then what use is it? It's just the most obvious joke.
I'm proud of you, Gamma.
Yeah, man, I got it. Are you proud, Wesley? Would you like me to wear the maid skirt, Wesley? It's the least I can do to further impress you. Uh-oh. Oh, no. They all just got beamed away.
You will get a new assignment.
So the weird implication behind that is that he just kicked them all out of the friggin' egg carrier. In what way? I guess he just beamed them all down because we've seen the thing beam them up, but damn, dude, that sucks.
Just get me that bird.
Oh yes, we'll find a girl and a bird.
No.
That's right. Who could this girl and bird be? Oh god, excuse me. Oh god, that was disgusting. Oh, that felt horrible.
Is this the one?
The one I'm pointing at. Whoa. I do how the spinny floor threw him off. I like that. This is a rather unsettling scene though, right here.
Beta.
this is the wrong
room. That is a fantastic line. Be it for comedic purposes or like to actually build up the drama. That's I love that's such a simple line of dialogue that can be taken in so many ways. But no, guys, that was a beautiful scene, all right? When Gamma was seeing Beta being reconfigured and put back together in a different way, he became aware of his own immortality. Okay, he became aware that he is only machine, and thus yearned for the mortality of man. All right, it's making him more relatable. It's making him more human. Okay, all right, it's a beautiful scene.
What the hell was that egg right there? All right, that is not at all what the Black Chow egg looks like in DX. To me, that was one of the more like jarring differences in this game for me. I'm like, that egg looks awesome. Why did they just make it flat black pastel texture? But anyway.
Resistance is futile.
No. Give me the bird, Wesley. She's like, who's Wesley?
Why not?
Who is that? My name's Amy.
Data unavailable.
You don't even know? I bet you'd be mean to him, you bully. Why not help us out instead?
I know you are, but what am I, Wesley?
Don't you know how bad I feel?
Does not.
I don't give a shit.
Why try to save that which is useless to you? Does not.
That's presumptuous. You don't know that.
I feel sorry for you. Eggman failed to give you feelings.
You weren't even made into a real boy, Pinocchio. This is something of a Pinocchio story. There are some parallels. Oh. Birds. I love birds.
Get going.
Huh?
Go. This is a jailbreak.
Why are you letting us go?
It is dangerous here.
I call dibs on that Black Chow egg, Wesley.
Arriving at the Mystic Ruins base soon.
True story, bro.
So, you're not like those other robots.
So another model that looks a million times better in the in this Dreamcast original. I have to say, I think Amy's model looks a million times better on the Dreamcast version. She looked like angry and like weird looking in the DX one, sort of like Knuckles. And just like with Knuckles, not only is her like fur texture way better in this, but she doesn't look all angry, and she actually looks like a kid. So I'm a fan. Look at this. Look at this Chow Egg, man. Look how cool it is. It's like the Chow Egg from hell. I love it. I want it so bad. When I was playing this for the first time, the Dreamcast original, when I was actually like playing through it, when I bought this, Oh yes, right. Jeez, when are we gonna end this episode? We're going on to 24 minutes now. There's no such thing as an episode that is too long, Wesley. Get up to the deck, the ammunition room is unlocked. Okay. Alright. Maybe we'll yeah, whatever. I'll go and put the chow in the chow garden and then we'll end the episode. Just cause I just kinda wanna get this. In my garden. Don't really know why, I already have a black chow, but it's not like I pay attention to him, really. I have like a Sonic Chow that I pay more attention to. There we go. Ta-da! I don't know if I ever actually showed off my Chow yet. I probably haven't. Well, maybe briefly. I think I did at the beginning. Oh, whoops, I didn't mean to set down the egg. No! No! Wesley, why? Wesley, you have broken and shattered my spirits. Ah, shit. Oh god, I'm shooting animals out of me. Okay, well, I guess that's not happening. Yay, at least I can like hover over the water because there's a lot more of it. So that's exciting. But anyway, I guess I'll just do that in between episodes or whatever. And in the next episode, we'll make our way to the ammunition room and get a little goodie that Wesley is hoping to give to us as a gift. What a lovely, thoughtful master. Ooh, I was still like hovering for a while there. That was kind of cool. Yeah, why do I hover on the sand? Am I not an ATV? I suppose not. Whoa, I just noticed that Gamma's eyes like zoom out like crazy when he's hovering. Why does he do that? That's weird. Look how far out they go. What the hell? They like bulge. That's so strange. Weird. Anyway, whatever. Peace. For all I know, that could be a bug in the model. I don't know. I love how he can jump. I just... I love playing in the water, Wesley. I love it. Will you give me swimming lessons, Wesley?